In this world, we have our troubles, sometimes lonesome and sometimes blue. But the hope of life eternal brightens all our hopes anew. I don't want
welcome into the Gospel Music Jukebox. I don't want to get adjusted to this world. Hey, I'm your host, Evangelist Eddie Chaney, saying we love you, but God loves you most, my friends. All right, we're going to be talking about, well, the question that's going around, the famous talk is, God loves everyone. Have you ever wondered how many times God loves everyone is found in the Bible? Is it 20, 50, 100? Maybe 200. Have you ever wondered if it appears in the New Testament or Old Testament or maybe both? Have you ever wondered how many times Jesus said God loves everyone? Throwing a little homework at you. If you really listen to the programs and pay attention, you'll always know that you're going to hear the truth here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. You see, I don't fear what man can do to me. I fear God, the one that can destroy both body and soul in the lake of fire, in that lake of torment where the worm dieth not, my friend. So we're throwing a little challenge out to you, a little bit of homework for you, research, back up what you say with the Word of God. I know that John 3:16 is always cited as support for God loves everyone. But of course, that verse does not say these words. Now, if you look in the information form, I put in some of the verses there, amen, that shows the context of this often referenced Bible verse for this topic, God loves everyone. And if you notice, I started in John 3:15, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Now, notice that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Then, the one that they use the most, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Look at 18. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Look at 19. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. Look at verse 20. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, and neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. Now where did it say that God loves everyone? That's the question we're throwing out to you. We hear it talked about, used everywhere we go throughout this world. But, I've always said, back it up with the Word. If you can't back up what you're doing with the Word, then you ought to quit doing it. The truth, right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio Program. We love you, but God loves you most. Know that. There's hope, oh. There's hope. There's good news. Yes, there is. And that is, if you feel that Holy Ghost conviction drawing power today, right now, right there where you're at, and you run to Christ with a broken heart and a contrite spirit, my friends, he'll no wise cast you out. Today is the day of salvation. Right now, this moment, this hour, what are you going to do with Jesus? That's what it's about today on the Gospel Music Jukebox. As always, uplifting the name of Jesus through word, testimony, and song. Hey, be sure to tell your friends, neighbors, family, co-workers, and yes, even your enemies, what's going on right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. The truth being broadcasted to a lost and dying world. Be blessed. We'll be right back. And hey, utilize those testimony lines. We're going to be sharing some of those throughout the program today. So you want to jump in there and dial 1-931-229-0768 and share your pre-recorded testimony or comment or prayer request. Or maybe you have a desire to pray for someone else, an interceder. Maybe you need to pray for the drug addicted or the alcoholic or the homeless or the widow or the orphans. We just want to encourage you to obey God. Pick up the phone, dial 1-931-229-0768, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. You can leave your pre-recorded testimony or comments. We're going to play them on the radio as well as burn them down to a CD and give them away free wherever we go, to homeless shelters, nursing homes, tent revival, wherever we're found spreading the gospel. So we're asking you to help us get the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ, out to a lost and dying world. Pick up the phone and be an overcomer. Yes, you're an overcomer by the word of your testimony and the blood of the Lamb. You must put your faith to work. Faith without works is dead. It's time to be a doer, not a hearer only of the Word of God. We're asking you for your help. Be blessed, and we'll be right back. You're listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox, and God's people, hey, they're happy people.
Somebody say amen. Somebody start ringing a bell.
Heaven knows there's a whole lot of trouble living down here below.
But we're smiling because when this whole life is over, we got someplace else to go.
Whoa, whoa. God's people are happy people, happy all of the time. Joy higher than the tallest steeple, love of the unstoppable kind. More than 10 million reasons running through my soul and my mind. God's people are happy people, happy people shine.
Everybody shout
believe.
Be a friend to the world. See how much love you can give.
Life is more than the air you're breathing, or spending more than you can afford. But happy are the people who always remember that happiness is the Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
God's people are happy people, happy all of the time. Joy higher than the tallest steeple, love of the unstoppable kind. More than 10 million reasons flooding through my soul and my mind. People, happy people shine.
Shine, shine, shine. Happy people shine.
Shine, shine, shine. Happy people shine.
God's people are happy people. We read the end of the book. We know we're winners if we hold on and endure to the unchanging hand of the great I am. Amen. Wow. Praise God. I mean, this is better felt than it is told, my friend. If you don't have Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, if you have not accepted Christ today, right now, right there, today is the day of salvation. What are you going to do with Jesus? That's what it's come down to. And that's what we're talking about today. Throughout this program, we'll be discussing God loves everyone. I mean, think about it. And how many times is it in the Bible? So I want to give you a little research. I want you to run and find it as many times as you can. Where is God loves everyone found in the Bible? And how many times is it found? I've give you a job to do. Now, go to work. Amen. Back it up with the Word of God. Praise God. Ain't that awesome when you get challenged? I mean, it ain't just the fact that you're sitting around, you know, listening. Now, I've asked you to do something, which I do on this program continuously. We asked you to share your testimony. We asked you to pray about sharing a word or a song. We're always encouraging you to be an overcomer, to be a doer of the Word of God. If you say you're born again, bathed in the blood, if you're a child of God, you should want to use every asset to help get the gospel, the good news out, to let the world know that God's not dead. He's alive and actively working in your life. You would think that would be the case, but most of the time it's not, as we cry out daily, but we get very few calls. You know, it kind of reminds me, there'd be few that find a path and stay there on. That's the truth. Wide is the road, and many there be. I mean, come on, hell is enlarging its borders every day because people are falling into forms of religion and they're believing the lies of the world and the devil, and they're tickling one another's ears as they play patty cake and pat each other on the back. But reality is, it's not everyone that cries, Lord, Lord, is going to enter in, but those that do the will of the Father. Are you busy about the will of the Father this day in your life? If not, you can be. It's your choice. Choose you this day. Whom will you serve? I mean, if God truly loved everyone, then everyone in the Bible would be loved and admired by God, right? If this was true, you should be able to open the Bible anywhere from Genesis to Revelation and find everyone in the Bible going to heaven, right? And I mean, and receiving nothing but, well, loving attention from God? Of course, nothing could be further from the truth. I mean, if you really read the Word of God, as we encourage you to do each and every program, you know by chapter 3 of Genesis, the lie is undone. Yeah, when Satan is described, certainly, described there. You can see it if you read it for yourself. Certainly, mankind can agree that all creatures is destined. Is man destined? No. Think about it. Does God love everyone or those that do the will of the Father? Does the Lord, he for whosoever, do you believe? Did you believe? Can you believe? Yes, you can believe. If you, do you believe? That's what it's coming down to. And a tree is known by the fruit that it bears. If you say you believe in the Word of God, if you say you believe that Jesus came and that he hung upon a cross for you and that he died for you and the one drop of blood was shed for you and that you're one of those whosoever's and your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, then you will be a doer of the Word of God. You will be feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, visiting the widows and the orphans. You will be busy about the will of the Father. You will be crying loud, sparing not. You will be sharing the gospel at every opportunity because you know that we are at war and there are souls hanging in the balance. You know that we're running out of time. If you are born again, bathed in the blood, you are not just happy with 2, 3, 4 days a week of gathering at a building that they call the house of God, which they lie. That is not the house of God. You and I are the house of God. Do you hear me? We're the true church. We're the body of Christ, the children of God. Do you understand? He that lives in you is greater than he that is in the world. Comes down to the question, are you who you say you are? But there's many people that don't believe, they don't want to believe, and that's what we're talking about throughout the program. As I give you some homework, run over there and see how many times you can find it in your Bible that where God loves everyone. I mean, if you look in Genesis chapter 4, Cain slays righteous Abel. In Genesis chapter 6, God sees the wickedness of man was great in the earth and that every imagination of their thoughts of his heart was only evil continuously, and it repented. Are you there yet? Are you starting to recognize what's going on? I believe you are. I believe you're right on top of it. Amen. We're going to run over here right now. Check out the testimony lines as we give you some homework, challenging you to get into the Word of God and share with us here through the comments, or you can call in through the testimony line, or you can call in live right now at 1-931-484-4531 live right here at the studio and talk with me, your host, Evangelist Eddie Chaney. How many times have you found where the Word of God says that God loves everyone? Awesome. All right, let's check out the testimony lines. Be blessed in Jesus' name, my friends.
Hello, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. We love you all. We're praying for you, and God bless you. And had a busy day today. We've got a morning church service in the morning, and then one about 4:30 later in the afternoon, which keeps us busy, and I've been busy coordinating with different people who are helping out Pastor Edwin's orphan kids. We're going to get those kids helped again tomorrow. We've usually been doing that about every week or every week or two, and it keeps me busy talking to people around the country and stuff and in different places trying to coordinate to get these orphan kids helped. And my friend Wayne called, who was in prison. We're just always busy here trying to help these people that have been on drugs or helping orphan kids and doing different things. Jesus keeps us busy and helping out the churches too. James 1:22 says, but be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. And I sent Brother Eddie an email about this because we're called to be doers of the word, not hearers only. And that's why we're trying to help these orphan kids and stuff. See, look at verse 27. Pure and undefiled religion before God the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their trouble and keep oneself unspotted from the world. And other versions say, you know, we're supposed to take care of the orphans, the fatherless, and the widows, if you look at the different translations of that scripture. So that's why we're trying to be doers of the word and take care of those orphan kids, and we're trying to preach the word of God to these people that are in the prisons and on drugs and get them freed from those drugs and freed from their sins. We're trying to be doers of the word, but I see so many people out there that are just hearers. They love to go to church. They love to hear the word preached. But if you go and ask them to help orphan kids, so many of them don't want to do it. If you ask them to go tell people about Jesus and share testimonies and get people saved, they don't want to do it. If you ask them to pray for people, they don't want to look at prayer needs and pray for people. There's so many that don't. Jesus always said the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. There's so few doers of the word and so many hearers of the word. And I hope we can all be doers of the word and have action to our faith and go out there and change the world for Jesus. It's a serious thing because Jesus said in Matthew chapter 7, many will have said, Lord, Lord, and been hearers of the word and even gone to church and done healings and different things. But he'll tell them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity, because they weren't doers. They didn't do the good they should do. James 4:17 says, if you do to see to do good and don't do it, you're living in sin. So I hope we can all have action to our faith and be doers of the word and not hearers only. We love you all, and God bless you, and have a good day. Amen.
Streets of old Jerusalem, and to hear the stories told about the days of old. You'd see a garden in the night and hear a Savior cry, let this cup pass from me. If it thy will could be, then to walk that sorrow road where he bore my sinful load, to cross on Calvary's hill, where he did my Father's will, onto a borrowed tomb that's now just an empty room. What a blessing it would be, all these sights to see. No, I've never walked the streets of Jerusalem, nor viewed those hallowed sites where Jesus lived and died. But he's gone to prepare a land beyond compare. I'll stroll the streets of my hometown in the sky. Someday I'll walk down the streets of New Jerusalem. I'll see that city fair in all its beauty rare. I'll meet with those gone on as we gather around God's throne. Upon those streets of gold, in our new righteous robe, the marriage supper will be spread, where God's children will be fed. What rejoicing there will be as we crown Christ King of Kings. We'll sing redemption's song. We have finally made it home, where we'll live and reign with him eternally. No, I've never walked the streets of Jerusalem, nor viewed those hallowed sites where Jesus lived and died. But he's gone to prepare a land beyond compare. I'll stroll the streets of my hometown in the sky. I'll stroll the streets of my hometown in the sky.
Yes, praise God, hometown in the sky. Ain't gonna be long. I mean, quicker than you probably think. I mean, we're in the last, seconds of the last hour of the last day. For real. And we're running out of time fast. And their souls hanging in the balance. That's why it's so important that we stand up and proclaim the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. What time the arm of the Lord is stretched out. What time the mercy doors open. If you feel God tugging at your heart, my friend, right there where you're at, get things settled between you and God. Don't put it off. Don't reject Jesus Christ. The truth is, you're either blessed by God or you're cursed by God. Now, which one are you? Which one do you want to be? You see, if you seek, you'll find. If you knock, it'll be open. If you ask, you receive right now. But friends, there's coming a time and a day when we're going to stand before the Lord. And time as we know it will be no more. My goodness, you're either going to hear the Lord say, as Brother Boyd was sharing with us, you're either going to hear the Lord say, enter in or depart from me. Which will it be for you? If you reject Jesus Christ today after hearing the truth, it's because you love living and walking in darkness and you don't want no part of the light. Your fruit is telling on your tree, and be it made known, you're either blessed by God or cursed by God. Choose you this day, whom will you serve? Today is the day of salvation. If you're alive, if you're listening, thank God. He's got a purpose and a plan for your life. What are you going to do with Jesus right now? Right now is what counts. Yesterday, hey, it's done. Tomorrow ain't made it here yet. We don't have the promise of the next breath we are to take. Right now, this moment, right now, what are you going to do with Jesus? We pray that you accept the unchanging hand of the great I Am. Friends, we're praying for you. If you claim to be born again, bathed in the blood, then be up and about the Father's business. Be found guilty of being Christ-like. Be who God has called you to be. You better quit worrying about what man's going to do to you, and you better be concerned with what God can do. You better be concerned. You better have the fear of God and fear the one that can destroy both body and soul in the lake of fire, my friend, where the worm dieth not. You see, for I really believe, I really believe most of your churches, most of your people stuck in that former religion, they've lost the most important thing concerning their relationship with God, and that is fear. You see, we are to fear the Lord our God if we ever wish to develop wisdom in His Word. But sadly, a lot of the modern day churches have become lukewarm. My friend, get on fire for God. Be found guilty of being a doer of the Word of God. Hey, this is better felt than it is told. I mean, if you don't have the Spirit of God, well, and you're listening to us preach the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, it sounds foolish to you, because without the Spirit of God, you cannot discern spiritual things. But there's good news right now. Today, there's good news. You too can be adopted, drafted in. You too can repent and turn from your wickedness. You too can come and drink of this water that you'll never thirst again. I'm talking about living waters. Woo, praise God. I'm talking about taking a bath in the blood. I'm talking about a dose to the ghost. I'm talking about baptism with the Holy Ghost and fire. I'm talking about loving the Lord thy God with all your heart, mind, strength, body, and soul. I'm talking about keeping the Word of God and not being a hearer only, but being a doer of the Word of God. Hey, I give you some homework. Run over there. See how many times you can find it for us. We're anxiously awaiting your replies. Whether you're listening live or by way of the archive, you can still put comments in the comment box. I go back and check those. We'd love to hear from you. Or you can call the testimony line and be heard. Share your comments there, your prayer request, your song, your testimony, or just shout howdy. We'd love to hear from you. The testimony line is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Well, or until the Lord ends it all, right? You can call 1-931-229-0768 and let the world know that God's not dead. He's alive and actively working in your life. Be an overcomer today, my friend, with the word of your testimony and the blood of the Lamb. Amen. Cry loud and spare not. Praise God. But see how many times you can find where God loves everyone. How many times is that in the Bible, Old and New Testament? Is it 20, 50, 100, or 200? I mean, surely you wonder if it appears in the New or Testament or the Old Testament or both. Have you ever wondered how many times Jesus said God loves everyone? Run over there and find it and share it with us. We'd love to hear from you today. Amen. That's kind of what it's going to be about. I'm just going to keep encouraging you to get into the Word of God. And the purpose behind that is because I believe anything and everything you do should be backed up with the Word of God. I believe there's many spirits that come at us, and we're to try those spirits and see if they be of God. How do you try a spirit? You line it up with the Word of God. If it does not line up with the Word of God, it's not of God. And garbage belongs in a garbage can, my friends. All right, we're going to jump in and check out the testimony line. Be blessed as we listen in.
Well, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. Love y'all. I'm praying for you. We're pretty busy today. We had a morning church service, and we got another afternoon one about 4:30, and we've been busy trying to coordinate it to get those orphan kids helped out with Pastor Edwin tomorrow. I just called in a little bit ago and shared my testimony and preached a little bit on James 1:22, and I wanted to say a prayer right now for us to be able to be doers of the Word. Father, I love you with all my heart, mind, and soul. I want to come to you in prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins and for shedding his blood so that our sins can be forgiven. May we never take that death for granted, Father. May we have the love of Jesus in our hearts and lives and truly be set free from our sins because Jesus died for us a horrible, painful death. May we die to ourselves, to our sins, and may we go out there and be doers of the Word, living for Jesus since we love him so much and he died for us. It says in James 1:22, but be doers of the Word and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. Father, I do see so many people that are just hearers. They go to church and believe the prosperity gospel, live the way they want, and they will take $4,000 or $5,000 trips, and they won't help these orphan kids like the orphan kids we're working with Pastor Edwin. There's so many of them. And they don't want to pray for people. They don't want to share testimony. It says they overcame them by the word of their testimony, and so many people won't share testimonies. If they share their testimonies, they can change people's lives and get people saved and change their lives by sharing their testimonies with others. I pray and ask, Father, that we can be doers of the Word and not hearers only, that we can share our testimonies with people, that we can help those orphan kids. It says in James 1:27, pure and undefiled religion before the God the Father is this, is to visit the orphans and widows in their trouble and keep oneself unspotted from the world. Father, may we keep ourselves unspotted from the world, and may we take care of those orphan kids and the homeless people and the needy people as we're called to do in the parable of the sheep and the goats. May we be doers of the Word and not hearers only, deceiving ourselves. May we be able to teach our friends and tell our friends about Jesus and help many people find Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior and get saved. James 4:17 says, therefore, to him who knows to do good and doesn't not to him in his sin. Father, I pray and ask, we'll have love in our hearts, and as we see good to do, we'll do the good and help people and tell them about Jesus and help the needy people. Please help us, Father, all to be doers of the Word and not hearers only, so we can one day be welcomed into heaven and not called workers of iniquity and told to depart. If we're not doers of the Word, Jesus may say, depart from me, I never knew you, workers of iniquity. God, I pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. God bless all. We love you. Amen.
Been dead for 4 days already. His family in sorrow, his friends full of pity. Jesus, where were you? We sent for you so long ago. You could have healed him. He loved you, don't you know? Then Jesus said, stand back and you'll not forget this day. And they saw a dead man walking and they heard stand and testify. The Son of God has raised me, and I have new life. Coming out of the tomb, stepping into the light.
in sorrow, his disciples hid away. Roman soldiers stood guard over that resurrection door, hoping to seal inside our Savior and Lord. But I can feel the ground is shaking, and that stone begins to move. And I can see a dead man walking, and he's coming out of the tomb.
Coming out of the tomb,
stepping into the light. Death has been defeated, I'll stand and testify. The Son of God is risen, and Jesus is the light. Coming out of the tomb, stepping into the light.
Morning service today, church service, we got one this afternoon, but I was calling in to say a prayer for God to heal and help anyone who needs healing and help hearing this. Father, I love you with all my heart, mind, and soul. I come to you in prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins, for shedding his blood so that our sins can be forgiven, so that our sicknesses and diseases can be healed. It says in Matthew 8:17 that Jesus took our infirmities and carried our diseases. Above that, it says he healed all who were sick. He cast out the demons. He loved them and healed them and helped them. And I know that Jesus loves us all so much. It says in Ephesians 3:20 that you're able to do exceedingly abundantly above anything we ask, think, or imagine. It says in Luke 18, verse 27, the things which are impossible with men are possible with God. Father, you have made the stars, the millions and billions of stars in the night sky. You know them each by name. You've made the earth, the mountains, the lakes, the rivers, the oceans, everything that exists. You have unlimited power in our lives to do the impossible, to make all things possible. And I thank you so incredibly much, Father, for bringing this power into our lives and for helping anyone hearing this who needs help. It says in Psalm 100, make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God, and it is he who has made us. We are not ourselves. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, his truth endures to all generations. I thank you, Father, that you are a very good, great, and incredible God, and that truly nothing is impossible with you. And because Jesus died on the cross, we are healed by the stripes, wounds, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. It says in Psalm 103, you forgive all of our iniquities, heal all of our diseases, and redeem our life from destruction. I'm praying and asking you right now to touch and heal anyone hearing this who needs healing and help in their lives. We are healed. We are claiming our healing. I am totally healed of any of those food allergy and eating problems. I'm standing on faith that I am healed. May we all stand on faith and know that we are healed. May you deliver us from any trials, challenges, and hardships we face in our lives. It says in Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. We can do all things. It says in Philippians 4:6, we don't have to be anxious about anything, but in everything, my prayer and petition with thanksgiving, we can present our requests to you. Thank you, Father, for delivering us from our trials, challenges, and hardships. And thank you. We do not have to worry because you are helping us. You are an incredible God. Nothing's impossible with you, and you're healing us and helping us with whatever we need help with in our lives. I love you, Father. I thank you so much, and I pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless all.
Time is filled with swift transition. Love,
of earth unmoved can stand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand.
Friends and neighbors, are you doing your homework? I pray that you are. I pray that we have said something or encouraged you to get into the Word of God. We've asked for you to research and show us as many times as you possibly can, whether it be 200, 50, 100, or 20 times. How many times does it say in the Word of God that God loves everyone? And that's kind of what we're talking about throughout the program. Amen. So you want to just drop it in the comment box, or you can call in live with your comment right here at 1-931-484-4531 and be heard right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox. All right. Talking about, man, thank Brother Boyd London for sharing those testimony calls. He is faithful. I'm telling you, he's an anointed man of God. He loves sharing the gospel. I know that he has that burn in him because his fruit tells on him. You know what I'm saying? He's like that city, a light that cannot be hid. Hey, man, that's what we're encouraging each and every one of you to do. Be like that city that's set on a hill that cannot be hid. We're running out of time. We got to let our light shine now, if we ever did in this world, because we're in the last seconds of the last hour of the last day, and the clock will stop. Whether you like it or not, believe it or not, ready or not, it will stop. And one day you will find yourself standing before the Lord thy God, and besides him there is none other. And you will hear him either say, enter in or depart from me. What are you going to do with Jesus today? Amen. All right, guys, you know, if you really think about it, you know, as you think about if God truly loved everyone, then everyone in the Bible would be loved and admired by God. if this was true. You should be able to open the Bible anywhere from Genesis to Revelation and find everyone in the Bible going to heaven and receiving nothing but, well, love and intention from God. But of course, nothing could be further from the truth. Let me give you some examples. We'll start in the beginning. We'll start in Genesis. Amen. Remember, Cain kills Abel, and you know, talking about when God rejected Cain's sacrifice, you can see it there in Genesis 4:7-11 and Jude chapter 11. But God rejected Cain's sacrifice, but accepted his righteous brother Abel's sacrifice. So Cain killed Abel, and God cursed Cain from the garden and sent him into the land of Nod. You know, so think about that as you think about now. Interesting theory. God loved who? Who did God love? Who does God love today? Who does God love? What does God love? What does God love? Interesting. I need your help. Get us some Bible. Jump in there. Get involved. Help us share the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. Now listen, I've got good news for you. I know sometimes it sounds gloom and doom, but if you'll stay, hang around, and endure to the end, and then give the matter honest judgment and a fair weight, you'll see there's good news, and his name is Jesus Christ. Yes, there's hope for the alcoholic. There is hope for the child molester. There's hope for the murderer. There is hope for those that are cursed by God. You're either blessed or cursed. You're either right or wrong. You're either saved or lost. You're either on your way to heaven or on your way to hell. There ain't no middle ground. Bottom line, where, if you meet death this moment, this hour, right now, where would you spend eternity? You know, because if you leave this world without Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, it's guaranteed you will lift your eyes in the lake of fire. Sin cannot go where Jesus is. Do you hear me, friends? Talking to you now. All right. Look in, also you can look in Genesis chapter 6, the whole world, you know, before the flood executed, there was, God destroyed the entire, you know, old world except Noah and his family with a flood because of their extreme wickedness. I mean, we're talking about lots of people. Estimated, I think it was in the billions, drowned by the flood, and it lasted 40 days and nights. You wanna get into that. Now, think about it. What's being said in these end times and the false lies that's going forth to deceive people, called in the form of religion, called in these buildings, they herd them in like cattle, like sheep being led to the slaughter, and they preach stories and fables. They scratch their itching ears. They're hirelings. They're for sale. You understand? There's men standing in these buildings that are wolves in sheep's clothing. Oh, they look the part. They sound the part, but they're not preaching the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ. They're not preaching Jesus and him crucified. You don't hear the blood being preached. You don't hear the truth being told, because people wouldn't stay, because the word of God says they wouldn't stay. It says there's many that are on the wide road that leads to destruction. Hell is enlarging its borders every day. It's getting bigger every day because people are rejecting the truth. They don't want their sins reproved. And that's the truth. Now, whether you want to accept it or not, it ain't going to change the word of God. It ain't going to change the fact that the truth is the truth, and the truth shall stand when the world's on fire. I'm asking you, does God love everyone? God loves everyone. Where's it at in the Bible? How many times have you found it so far? 20, 50, 100, 200? Hey, share it with us. We'd love to see where you found it. Share it with us. That's what we're encouraging you to do, to get into the Word of God for yourself, to get in there, to fast and pray and seek the guidance of the Holy Ghost, because you have no need that any man would teach you anything concerning Christ. Listen, if you will yield to the Holy Ghost, you'll never go wrong. Get into the Word of God. There's power in the Word of God. Recognize who you are in the body of Christ. stand up and cry aloud and spare not. It's time. It's time. We're running out of time, and there's souls hanging in the balance. There's people watching you, and they've watched people play church for so long, it's made them sick. They just jump in now to fit in. I mean, oh, you get privileges if you sign their book. Yeah, man, they'll check on you and your mom. They'll help you as long as you sign their book and you tie to that building and you take an oath that you'll support that ministry. And they say they'll support you, but they don't. What do they do for you unless your name is on the book, on their book? You know, the only book that's going to count is God's books, and the books are going to be opened, and I'm talking about books, meaning plural, more than one. Do you hear me today? I'm talking to you. The truth is going forth from the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio program as we reach out through the Project Reach Out, and we try to make a difference in people's lives. We tell them the truth, and then we get involved in their life. Do you understand? We're not hearers only of the Word of God, but doers. Are you a doer of the Word of God? Are you proclaiming? Are you standing upon the promises of God? Do you read daily? Do you pray without ceasing? Do you ask God first thing in the morning to direct your path, to use you, a willing vessel? Hey, if you do, you'll go places you never thought you'd go. You'll say things you never thought you would say, and you will definitely do things you never thought you would do. God's good. And he's presented you with a choice to choose whom you will serve this day. You see, you must believe. If you don't believe that Jesus Christ is the only begotten Son of God, and you reject Jesus Christ, you're condemned already. You are guaranteed, if you leave this world without Jesus Christ, you will lift your eyes in torment. You will lift your eyes in the lake of fire. You will lift your eyes in a hellish torment, separated from God for eternity. And there's a lot of people that choosing that in these end days. Their fruit is telling on them. But we must continue to cry loud and spare not. We must continue to share the truth, the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, and let them know there is a way of escape from this world. And all you have to do is repent. Turn from your wickedness. If you feel that Holy Ghost drawing conviction power tugging at your heart, if you're tired of the world and the worldly ways, you're tired of living a lie, you're tired of running from God, run into God. Come to that place and realize you're a sinner in need of a Savior, and reach out and take a hold of that unchanging hand of the great I Am. If you'll come to him with a broken heart and a contrite spirit, my friend, he'll take you. Won't you jump up on the potter's wheel right now, right there where you're at? For today is the day of salvation. Choose you. Whom will you serve this day? Right now, this is what counts. Listen, yesterday's gone. You can't change it. Tomorrow's not here. There's enough evil sufficient for today. Right now, make your choice. As you hear the truth, what are you going to do with Jesus Christ? What are you going to do with Jesus? Hey, I'm living like I'm leaving. What about you?
I know that any moment my ears could hear the trumpet that beckons me to rise to meet the Lord. Determined to live holy, to be a testimony, and hear him say, well done, here's your reward.
I'm living like I'm leaving, cause I might be leaving today. I'm working while I'm waiting, just praying and keeping the faith, keeping the faith. I'm on make a difference and share the gospel message till the Lord calls me away. I'm living like I'm leaving, cause I might be leaving today.
It's not a myth or fable, his word is true and faithful, so I'm looking for his coming in sky, and the signs that I am seeing.
again today. With every opportunity, I'll do my best to prove my mind is set on heaven, and I'm ready for the moon. Ready for the moon. I'm living like I'm leaving, 'cause I might be leaving today. Working while I'm waiting, just praying and keeping the faith, keeping the faith. I wanna make a difference and share the gospel message till the Lord calls me away. I'm living like I'm leaving, 'cause I might be leaving today. I'm living like I'm leaving, 'cause I might be leaving today.
Amen. I'm living like I'm leaving, 'cause I may be leaving today. Listen, we don't have the promise of the next breath we are to take, my friend. Are you ready? Beyond a shadow of a doubt, have you got things worked out between you and God? Have you cast your cares upon Him, for He cares for you? Today is the day of salvation. What are you going to do with Jesus? Amen. All right, guys, we've been asked the question, so we're passing it along. We're asking you, God loves everyone, right? How many times have you found it in the Bible? Can you share it with us? Have you found it 20, 50, 100, 200, 500? I mean, where is it at? Is it in the New Testament, the Old Testament, or both? Have you ever wondered how many times Jesus said God loves everyone? We'd love to hear from you. Love to hear your comments on this question. Amen. As we asked, where is God loves everyone found in the Bible? Amen. All right, we're just going to jam out and raise our hands. We're just going to worship the Lord for a few moments right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox as we listen to the gospel of Jesus Christ through song right here, right now. Be blessed, because, man, it ain't one of these days we're going to be walking in New Jerusalem. Those of us that are born again, bathed in the blood, those of us that have chose, those of us that believe, those of us that believe, do you believe? I believe that Jesus Christ is the only begotten Son of God. I believe that He came and died upon an old rugged cross there on Calvary for whosoever. I'm one of them whosoevers. Are you? You can be. If you come to that place and realize that you're a sinner in need of a Savior, if you recognize that you can repent and come out from amongst the world and be ye a separated people, what are you going to do with Jesus? As for me, I'm holding on to the unchanging hand of the great I Am. One of these days, I'm going to be walking in Jerusalem just like John. Be blessed. We'll be back in a little bit. We're just going to listen to some music and worship the Lord for a little bit in spirit and truth. Let's just have a little church right here. Amen. Praise God. Raise your hands up and worship God.
John, oh John, what did you say?
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I'll meet you there on the crowning day.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready,
Lord. Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Someday we'll rise and shine in glory,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till then I'll tell the gospel story,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready,
Lord.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John. Trumpet blow,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till Jesus said it's time to go,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready,
Lord.
walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Listening for the call.
I wouldn't change nothing for my journey now. I gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil tempts me and tries to turn me around, offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I'd won and your worldly fame. If I could still, I wouldn't take another form of journey now. No, no,
started out traveling for the Lord many years ago. I've had a lot of heartaches, had a lot of grief and woe.
Tempts me, tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I've won and worldly fame. If I could steal, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. We'll be right back. never buys mine. He touched from above. Then I'd say I wouldn't dang nothing for my journey now, no, no.
I wouldn't dang nothing for my journey now. I've got to make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil tempts me and tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name. All the wealth I've won and worldly fame. Still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
If I could, still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
Praise God, church in the kitchen. Hey, where two or three are gathered up in His name, He is in the midst. Amen. All right, church. I want to invite you to drop back in with us at about 8 p.m. Central Time tonight as we do the Gospel Music Jukebox one more time tonight. Amen. I pray that we've stirred up the gift within you. I pray that you get into the Word and you share the Gospel with a lost and dying world. I pray that if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal, precious Lord and Savior, that right there, right now, where you're at, you would get things right between you and God, that you would realize today is the day of salvation. Choose you whom you will serve. We're praying for you. We're praying that you reach out and take a hold of that unchanging hand of the great I Am, my friend. Amen. God is awesome. He's awesome. And besides Him, there is none other. Amen. We've asked the question, we're hoping to hear from you, where is God loves everyone found in the Bible? I'd love to hear from you. Share the verses. If you found it 20, 50, 100, maybe 2, 500 times, share them in the comment box. Share with us, where does it say God loves everyone? We'd love to hear it. We hear that statement said all the time in these forms of religion and all throughout this world that we live in, but we've come out from amongst. We hear that said all of the time. But, you know, if you begin to read the Word of God and apply the Word of God in your life and stand upon the promises and the Word of God, man, you find out that it ain't that away. It really ain't. Look for yourself, read, and apply the Word of God into your lives, my friend. We've shared a few examples with you there in the Old Testament, but just get into the Word of God. You can look in Acts 24, verses 5 and 6, Acts 26, verse 24, 1 Corinthians 2 and 4, Ephesians 3 and 12, 1 John 4 and 17. 1 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 9 and 10. And I mean, the list goes on and on. Look at Revelation 11, 10. Allow God to write his word upon the tablet of your heart. You know what 2 Timothy talks about there in chapter 4, when he's talking about preach the word, be instant, in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. I believe it's Titus 2 and 15. He said, these things speak and exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no man despise thee. Jump into the Word of God for yourself. That's what we're trying to encourage you to do. Many people do not want to read the Word of God because they absolutely know that the Word of God is going to call the sin out of their life and they're going to have to make a choice. They're going to have to give it up. Once you know the truth, and the truth shall set you free, but if you reject Jesus Christ, he is the truth. If you reject him, you're condemned already. What are you going to do with Jesus? That's what it's come down to this day, this hour, the last seconds of the hour of this day, as we're running out of time and their souls hanging in the balance. Please, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, repent. Recognize you're a sinner in need of a Savior. If you feel that tug, don't you reject him. Don't you walk away. Don't you let go. We love you. We're praying for you. Hope you drop back in tonight at 8 p.m. Central Time right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio Program. My God, we're stirring up the gift that lies within you, my friends. We're encouraging you to get involved. Remember to call our testimony line. We'd love to hear from you. That's 1-931-229-0768. And be an overcomer with the word of your testimony and the blood of the Lamb. Overcome the enemy in your life. Help us share the gospel, the good news, the truth. Amen. Right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio Program. We'd love to hear from you. And as always, when we're on the air live, hey, we encourage you. We ask you to pray about calling in and participating live. Anytime you see the live button and I'm host, you can call 1-931-484-4531 and be heard right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox. Hey, we want to thank all of you for stopping by and checking our program out. Check out the archives. We've got Bible study. Hey, check out Brother Willie Grizzle of the House of Prayer. You want to be a blessing and be blessed. Jump in, check out the archives. Let us know what you think about the programs. And if they've touched you in any way and encouraged you to grow closer with God, we'd love to hear from you. We'd love to hear about it. May God continue to bless you as you continue to be a blessing to others, my friends. We'll see you tonight. Lord's willing, unless I'm gone, then guess what? You're on your own. Hey, we love you. But God loves you most. Come on. Get into the Word of God. Share the Scriptures. Cry loud and spare not. And you too can have a soul on fire for God. We'll see you tonight. Lord's willing. God bless.
till I am a soul on fire. God, I'm running for your heart. I'm running for your heart till I am a soul.
Yeah.